Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about some problems you might be seeing if you have a poorly insulated cathedral ceiling. So, the major ones, heat loss, which can also lead to snow melt, which can lead to ice dams. So, the big thing where you're going to have heat loss usually will come from poor insulation, or insulation that has broken down over time, such as fiberglass. Now, you don't often see cellulose in a cathedral ceiling, however, if you do, it can have the same issues, breaking down, settling, it can pull down to the bottom of the, down by the soffit, bottom of the cavity, and it can leave a big gap at the top near the ridge or the peak. So again, you have gaps caused by broken down insulation. Of course, like we said, this will all go back to heat loss. Heat loss by itself can have a bunch of issues, of course, snow melt, which can lead to ice damming and other problems. So how would we fix that? Now, keep in mind, cathedral ceilings, you have very limited space to work with. And we have some other videos and articles talking about the best ways to insulate that. But keep in mind, you have a limited space in there. So whatever you put in there, it's already kind of a challenge. The other thing to keep in mind is thermal bridging. We also have some other things talking about thermal bridging in more detail. But I want you to keep these in mind so that you know it's already a struggle of an area to work with. So you want to use the absolute best material, such as foam insulation. Having a material that stays in place and establishes an air seal will be crucial. Anytime you put fiberglass or cellulose in, somewhere can have the issue of breaking down. And in a cathedral ceiling, like we said, already an area that has problems. So when you put that in there, it's going to make that even worse. So if you notice things like, you know, big patches of snow melt all around your cathedral ceiling or the roof above that, and if you look down by the eave or the soffit and you see big ice dams, again, that's from snow melt, which came from heat loss. So the whole thing is you want to stop that heat from getting out. Now, aside from those inherent problems that cathedral ceilings can have, you want to try to stop that as best you can. So if you're experiencing these problems, please check out some of our other articles that talk about the best ways to insulate your cathedral ceiling, as well as check out some of our videos. Hope this information was helpful. Please drop us a comment if you have a cathedral ceiling and you're seeing these issues, if you're seeing snow melt, if you're seeing lines on your roof. Tell us about it. Let us know. I'm sure we can help you out. Be sure to like this video. Subscribe to our channel. We got all kinds of great videos like this. And don't forget to hit that bell so you see all of our notifications. And that's how the foam's applied. Oh, excuse me. Professor of Foam here. How can I warm you up?